Dear friends, although virtually, allow me to welcome you all to this first Balkan Forum in 2020 against anti-Semitism. This is a forum that is hosted by the Albanian Parliament in partnership with the Combat Anti-Semitism Movement and the Jewish Agency for Israel. The Parliament of Albania is really honored to have in today's forum the participation and the contribution of prominent personalities and great friends of both Albanians and Jews, the State Secretary Pompeo and the President of the European Parliament, Sassoli, whom I extend my gratitude for joining this initiative of our Parliament. Our gratitude for the senior authorities of the United Nations, similarly for the senior authorities of the State of Israel. We would also like to thank the speakers of Kosovo, North Macedonia, Montenegro, the diplomatic corps, the experts who will contribute in this forum, and for hundreds of pupils and students who are following us virtually online. This extensive participation makes this forum a regional festival of humanism, of love, peace, tolerance, and justice. This forum takes place just a few days following the adoption by the Albanian Parliament of the resolution on the adoption of the working definition for anti-Semitism as defined by the International Alliance on the Remembrance of the Holocaust. The resolution and the forum are two firm steps that join Albania to the efforts of the contemporary world in one of its most significant and symbolic acts in the fight against anti-Semitism. All nations who aspire towards democracy, pluralism, diversity, and tolerance should join the front against anti-Semitism. Albania believes that to combat anti-Semitism is a huge responsibility for our whole civilization, but also because we need to deserve this privilege of being part of everybody who is on board on the fight against anti-Semitism. In this world, nations make their own choices. We, Albanians, remain stoic to our choice that love versus hatred, tolerance above conflict, human affection above persecution, suffering above causing it to others. And for us, Albanians, history has frequently placed us on the same boat as the Jewish people, the people that have suffered this tragic fate, but whose pains, however, caused by history, didn't diminish their grandeur or their humanity. The cultural and human relations between Jews and Albanians have a history of over 2,000 years. In the south of Albania, only some tens of kilometers away from my hometown, since the 5th century, in the very same building, one could find both a church and a synagogue. This is an absolutely rare case, perhaps the only one in history. In Albanian traditional culture, we have what we call the oath. And we have an expression which says, for that Saturday and for 700 years coming, which shows that relations with the Jews have become an important element in our existence, because we're taking an oath on the Saturday and the 700 coming years. Albania has served as a backup land for the Jews in difficult times, and it is the only country in Europe where all the Jews were taken in under the protection of the Albanian citizens and rescued during the Second World War. And this attitude made the League of Nations to recognize the Albanian state in 1926, the legal authority as a country of Jewish temporary residents, and even the right to issue documents for their movement. And the world recognized Albanians as the magistrates for the protection of Jews, regardless of religion, wealth, or territory, political orientation, thus marking a national convergence as has rarely been the case. In standing by our strategic allies, the United States of America and the European Union, in the fight against Semitism, anti-Semitism, we actualize what previous generations have done for the protection of the four waves of Jews arriving in Albania, which occurred during the terrible years, in dramatic periods, and were driven by dark impulses. Therefore, in the first century, to escape slavery in Rome, similarly, in the 15th century, to escape Inquisition, the 17th century, to escape persecution by the Ottoman Empire, and yet again during the Second World War, to escape the Holocaust, one of the most horrific and cruelest attacks on humanity. In my capacity as Speaker of the Albanian Parliament, I curtsy to the memory of the generations that made us proud of the history of the protection of the Jews, the memories of the Albanian families, Albanian citizens, and the institutions of Albania. It is true that Jews were protected by poor Albanian families, but the lists were on the hands of the government and the institution, and they did not hand them over to the persecutors of the Jews, thus joining the humanist instinct of the Albanian people. The fight against anti-Semitism protects not just a single nation, but it is part of humanity's project for a world full of prosperity, security, peace, and justice. Albania's leadership in this fight is not simply a matter of relations with the State of Israel, neither is it a matter of just our partnership with the United States of America, which have committed themselves to the protection of the Jews of Albania from Ambassador Bernstein in the 1930s, to Ambassador, to the present day Ambassador of the United States to Albania, Madam Kim. Our position stems from both history and existence, or from our aspirations to join the EU, from our NATO membership. It also stems from our alliance against terrorism and violent extremism, against violence against communities, minorities, refugees, immigrants, violence against the weak. It comes from the partnership to protect our future from the democratization of violence, which is associated to what we call the democratization of technology. Anti-Semitism, ladies and gentlemen, is not only directed against the Jews, but as a distillation of humanity from evil, it can threaten all nations. Anti-Semitism does not belong to the past alone. If we fail to be vigilant, it can also threaten our future. In conclusion, I would like to assure you that Albania will carry out its mission all the way to the end to make the fight against anti-Semitism an issue belonging to the entire region of the Balkans. By deserving, therefore, to be at the leadership of this front, we affirm our European, civilized, and Western identity and values. Thank you.